Maladi.
No, now we can, please. Yes, sir.
Hello. Okay. Good morning, trainees. So I'm welcome you for today's session. Today we have a wonderful teacher with us. Her name is Neeraja, Mrs. Neeraja. She is a practicing teacher working in Hyderabad in a primary school. And she also involved in textbook development and handbook development. You could see her name in our textbooks and handbooks also. And she is very active teacher in interacting with her students and telling stories and developing language through stories. So she is very passionate about teaching English for young learners, for primary learners. And now I welcome Neeraja to interact and take the session.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful introduction. First of all, my heartfelt thanks to Jani Reddy, sir, for discovering me. I am Jani sir's discovery. I was lying somewhere, but he discovered me and brought to this stage. I'm very thankful to you for that, sir. And then coming to today's session, good morning to everyone, all the participants. And how is your lockdown going on? Like, is everything locked up? Or there is a movement? Can I have some responses, please? So that I can be sure that I am reaching out to you. Lockdown lo em chestunaru?
Trainees, you can respond with the madam.
Madam.
Yeah.
Good morning, madam.
Lockdown lo.
Reading different kind of books and helping mother.
Very good. Helping mother, reading different kinds of books. Okay.
And regular, what we will do, we are continuing that regular process, ma'am.
Regular classes also you are continuing. So, okay.
Yeah.
Very good, very good.
This now, additional.
This is additional.
Yeah, that's it.
Good. You see, always these add-ons add up spice to life. If everything goes in a routine way, it's always routine. But these add-ons should be there to make our life a variety. Is it not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, right. I was just confirming that I am reaching out to you. सबको सुनाई दे रहा है या नहीं ये बात मैं पक्का करने के लिए बात कर रही थी आप लोगों से. अच्छा, तो लॉकडाउन तो बहुत मस्त चल रहा है. आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट. एंड कमिंग टू टुडेज टॉपिक, एज यू पीपल हैव सीन एंड एज आवर सर हैज टोल्ड, इट इज अबाउट स्टोरी टेलिंग. नाउ इट इज इनबॉर्न इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. Storytelling is nothing new to us. It is, we are born with that structure. We are born with that plan actually within ourselves. So it is nothing new or not at all new to us. Now coming to what actually are stories and why do they matter to us? I just want you people to have a look at this. What do stories do to us? Can you see? What stories
do to us? Yes. Please keep like that. Okay.
Help us. Okay, stories help us to.
Yeah, somebody should read out. Trainees?
Yeah, it is better, sir, so that even I can understand that.
Hello, trainees, somebody could read out.
Spark a connection. Stay motivated, relax and learn.
Yes.
Carry our cultural essence forward. Develop our own perspective, understanding the world better.
Yes. Now this is what stories do to us. Stories, they help us understand the world better. Our perspective, and also help us to understand others' perspectives. It helps us to develop our own perspective so that we can understand what is happening around us in the world, and also help us to understand others' perspectives. And when there is a story happening, whether it is in the reading form or whether it is oral storytelling, there is a connection between two different parties, like, you know, the reader or the listener, here the storyteller or the story writer. So there is a connection, not only between these two parties, but between us and the world outside us. You know, when we are reaching out to the world, we are reaching out it through the stories. And it, in addition to this, it also carries the cultural essence of our society. Each and every society, each and every community has stories of its own. They carry the culture. They carry the essence of the culture forward. And not only this, but stories make our mood lighter. They relax us. You know, whenever we listen to some story, read some story, or watch a story, it so happens that we get so relaxed and there is no stress at all in on our minds. And we feel so happy. And this happiness, this relaxation, this stress-free mind helps us to learn better. Because ultimately, whatever we are discussing now, we are taking back to the classrooms. Storytelling, we can discuss it for days together. There is volumes to discuss about storytelling. But because our time is limited and we have to take this back to classroom, I request you all to take the essence of this particular session to back to classrooms when you go there. Okay, so we have learned that stories are carriers of our culture. They build our perspective. They understand. They make us, help us to understand the world better. They create connection and many more things. You can add many more things. N number of things are there about stories. Now, when you come to story as such, when you come to story, I mean, what actually is a story composed of? What actually is there in a story? There are many ideas to this, but basically all can be broadly classified or categorized into four different headings. Those are elements of a story. Can somebody help me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What is elements the first of a story? Just tell me, what is this?
Setting, where and when.
Sophia, you close your video.
No, sir, video close only.
Okay. Right.
Right. So, Sophia, can you tell me what is this?
Setting, where and when.
Setting, where and when. Then, yes, is there somebody else to respond? Character. Who? Okay.
Character. And,
yes. What is this?
Problem. What? Why?
Yeah. What? I have kept why in brackets. Even that question can be answered. And what is this?
Solution. How?
Yes. How? Okay. Right. Thank you so much. Now you see, basically, these are the elements of a story. A story has to have a setting. Then it has to have characters. Then it has to have a conflict or a problem, and then a solution to that particular problem. So talking about these elements, if you come to setting, it answers the questions of when and where. Where is the story taking place? Is the story taking place in a city or in a village or in a forest? Or somewhere else on some other planet, because we have stories related, regarding our aliens and everybody. So anyway, setting is that answers a question regarding where and also when. when is the story taking place? Is it the present time story, or is it talking about the things that happened in the past? Say, when we talk about Tenali, Ramakrishna, Akbar, Birbal stories, or kings and emperors stories that happened in the past, we are talking about that timeline. So setting has to be very clear. It has to answer two questions regarding when and where. So where is the location? When is the timeline? And the stories can also be of future. You people, if you are interested in sci-fi stories and all those things, you people can read those stories also. What happens in future, there are many imaginations, and things are going around in creating stories about future. So setting relates to when and where. Then comes characters. The second important element of a story is characters. Who are the characters? You see, mostly we'll have a very important person who is leading the whole story, or around the whom the story is woven. You can call him protagonist or hero of the story, or whoever it is. Like, protagonist means the main important character, and the most probably the most positive character about of the story. And then there will be some sub characters who are also important to the central theme. Then we have antagonist, who is working against the protagonist. In our agar apne language mein bolna hai to apan bol sakte ke protagonist hero hota hai ya heroine hoti hai, aur jo antagonist hota hai wo story ke against mein rehta hai, matlab jo bhi plus rehta hai, jo bhi sabko acceptable rehta, uske against mein. Ante villain ancho kuch ante manaki kadalo characters ever untaru oka hero hero ante gender dantlo ellipoyi only males ni ankokandi. Hero of the story can be anybody. So vallaku sambandhinchina characters. Then you have someone who is plotting against this protagonist. Then you have a problem. A problem is a must. Otherwise, if I tell you a story, say for example, if you take this so very famous story of Bahubali, and tell Bahubali was unko em antaru ayani throne nundi teesesnaru, and Ballala Deva was the king now. Aa tarvata manchiga everybody was happy. Ayana akkada Bahubali ellipoyi akkada prajala madhyana happy ga batikesnadu. Ballala Deva ikkada batikesnadu. There is no story, there is no part two, there is no enthusiasm, there is no 1000 crores business. So there has to be a problem. Aa problem etla undali, andar lopala curiosity ni arise chestattu undali. ఎందుకు ఈ ప్రాబ్లం వచ్చింది, ఏం ప్రాబ్లం వచ్చింది, ఎట్లా వచ్చింది ఆ ప్రాబ్లం, ఈ అన్ని ప్రాబ్లం కి సంబంధించిన ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ యూ షుడ్ అందరూ చూసుకోవాలి. ఆ ప్రాబ్లం ఉండేటట్టు చూసుకోవాలి స్టోరీలో. దెన్ సొల్యూషన్, హౌ ఎట్లా సాల్వ్ అయింది ఆ ప్రాబ్లం, ఎట్లా సాల్వ్ అయింది. సొల్యూషన్ టు దట్ పర్టికులర్ ప్రాబ్లం ఈజ్ ఆల్సో వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఇఫ్ దీస్ ఫోర్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ ఫిక్స్డ్ ఇన్ అ స్టోరీ, very, what to say, glamorously, then it is a super hit story. I must say danni manchiga chudali evaru unnaru, ee story time ekkada jarugutundi, eppudu jarugutundi, ee place lo jarugutundi, vallaki em problem vachindi, aa problem ni manam etla solve chestunnam, hum kaise solve kar rahe hain jo problem apne characters face kar rahe hain. So if these things are fit in properly into the story, this thing, then it is a super hit story. Okay, so this is about story, elements of a story. I hope everyone got this. Yes, please put your hands up, raise your hand so that I can see at least.
Yeah, respond in your chat also.
Yeah, so yes, I mean, if there is anything, yeah, please tell me sir, connect to me. Okay. Yes, thank you so much. Thank you. Now,
if somebody is asking learned... something. Hello.
Sorry, sir. Pardon.
Somebody has yes, raised their voice.
Hi.
Yes.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ma'am, as you said, after reading the stories, we feel happy, but it depends on stories and which story is good, bad.
Yeah.
Which stories we have to read, means which is helpful for us.
Yes, sir. Can you please tell her doubt? Her audio is not clear.
Yeah, see, this is depend upon the person who is reading the stories. There are certain stories. For example, there are Tenali Ramalinga, Akbar Birbal stories. See, you have to teach the children all these stories so that they can learn about the world. They can also learn about how to live in the world and what kind of problems they face and how to resolve. This is how the teacher should know about the stories. There is no end good and bad, something like that. How you perceive it. Okay. So the stories, whatever the stories the children we are using in the classroom, it should be helpful for them to understand the world and also should solve the problems they come across in their day-to-day life. So all the stories are like that only. Whatever the stories we have in our culture, whatever the language it may be, stories carries the same messages. Yeah. Yes.
Yes, that is very correct, ma'am. Because as we said in the beginning,
Niraja, teacher, you can also tell them about what is the advantage of using the stories in the classroom, especially in English classroom, ELT.
Yes, sir. I'll come to that.
Yeah.
Now, see, as we said, we just saw what are stories and what are the elements of a story. Now, we are talking about storytelling, which is an oral performance. Reading stories is different from storytelling. In reading stories, you simply read them to yourselves or just read out to somebody. But storytelling, it is an art. It has to be narrated. You know, and it is based on emotions and images, mental images. And then it is a performance. It is not simply doing some task and going away. It actually involves interaction between you and the audience. And our audience here are going to be kids, children. So you have to be very, very careful that your performance is connected to them and how you can involve them emotionally so that they can create their mental images and also interact with you in a very free manner. So that is very important here. Now, as we said, why is storytelling important? Do we think storytelling in these days, that too, when you have everything, at the snap, you just snap and you have everything on your internet. And do we really think that it is important to tell stories to these high-tech kids? And the answer is undoubtedly yes, because it is what helps the children to develop a personal relationship, a social relationship. Watching videos on YouTube or watching something on the internet does not help them to develop these kind of bonds, these kind of relationships. This kind of thinking does not develop. This has a scope only during a storytelling session. So let us see why these telling sessions are very important to children apart from developing the language. Okay, when you see all these stories, whatever we are talking about, all these stories, all everything, they need a medium. And that medium is language. You can tell a story in your Telugu, or Hindi or English, whatever the language may be. But when children are listening to this particular story in one particular language, wherein we are considering it as our English, but it can be told in any language. And that language connects us. And that has to be taken care of very, very particularly. What language we are using and how are we connecting to the children. And let me just show you one more paper. Can you people see?
Yeah. Yeah.
Storytelling.
Just keep it in front. Okay. It's.
Yes, sir.
Somebody can read? Trainees? One of you can read it?
Yes, sir.
What does storytelling do for us? These are the answers what I have sorted out.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Boost the creativity.
Yeah.
Improves verbal skills. Mm-hmm. Motivates.
Trainees, you can write in the chat also by just reading it.
Engages emotionally,
encourages purposeful talking, improves listening skill, provides entertainment.
Increases.
Yeah, now it's okay. Yes, now it is increases understanding, attract audience, keep them engaged.
Yeah, I have left some arrows empty.
Improves verbal skills.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you see I have left some arrows empty here?
Yeah. Can you add some more trainings? Can you add some more ideas from the stories? How it is useful for the students? Hello, respond.
Yes, sir. Develop imagination.
Yes, okay. Good. Next. One body more student.
Gestures. Body gestures.
Pardon?
Body language, sir.
Body language also. Okay. The next. Expressive skills. Body language means to express your skills. Yeah. Next. So please respond. How stories are helpful?
Yeah. Have
empathy. Moral values. Of course, some
moral values.
Yeah.
Empathy and sympathy develop.
Empathy, okay. Neha, give the chance for others also. Yeah. Next.
Inspirable. It will be inspirable.
Inspiration. Yeah, get the inspiration also. Yeah.
Motivation.
Motivation. You will be motivated by listening stories. Yes.
Yes. Very good.
What else? What about language? Language aspect? Vocabulary, grammar, thinking. Yeah. Soumya said vocabulary, grammar, Shobarani thinking, Vinayasri creativity. Yeah. Next. Language aspect.
Okay. Sir.
Yeah. Yes.
Now, sir is asking about the language aspect, and as we said, the verbal skills, you know, verbal, they speak a lot, their listening skills are developed, they are engaged in purposeful talking. See, when children, if you people have gone to your classes, or if you people have just observed children anywhere, you might have noticed that they keep on talking, they never stop. And that is the beauty of childhood. You know, they always keep talking of something or the other. Whatever is available to them, whatever theme, whatever topic, whatever idea, concept, whatever is available to them within family, outside the family, on TV, about sports, about corona, everything they can speak of. Okay. So this talking can be channelized through storytelling. You can develop purposeful talking, so that they can develop communication skills. And not only this, but it increases the understanding, comprehension. So once the comprehension skills are enhanced, then you see children can do wonders. Not only children, all of us, you, me, and everybody. And another beautiful aspect of storytelling is they keep children engaged for a longer time than our regular class. When you take up a regular class, children finished, teacher, I pen, ho gaya, abhi kya karna, aur kya karna, and you also plan for a little thing and go. But when you go to a class planning a story, then you will notice such a beautiful change in students. You know, they'll be waiting for your next class. This happens to me. They wait for my class because I keep telling stories to them. I always keep them engaged with some activity that is related to stories. So this can happen with anybody. This can happen with everyone. So what we have to do is we have to choose our stories, and also we have to plan them meticulously so that what our objectives of storytelling are there, that can be realized, that can be, those can be achieved. Like, okay, yeah. So yeah. Which stories to tell? Now, I'm just answering all the questions in order. But if you people have any doubt, you can simply raise your hand and ask me. Once we finish the whole session, we'll have a question answer, open session, like, okay, open forum or whatever you call it. Then which stories to tell? That is a huge question. Now, somebody was asking which stories to tell, good stories, bad stories. See, anything can be said. Any event, any incident, any accident, anything can be transformed into a story. That is, I mean, that depends upon the storyteller. How well you can translate an incident into a story is your talent. So you have to be very careful about that. You can tell stories about animals. You can tell stories about mythological characters. You can tell stories, folk stories. You can tell historical ones. You can real life stories can be told about sportspersons, about scientists, about anything. There is no limit. Like, no, this about this you cannot tell a story about. Okay, you can tell stories about mathematics. You can tell stories about science, how the whole system works, and how we have to protect our environment, and how, you know, nowadays it is a trend that you should not give just numerical problems to mathematical, in mathematics. You are supposed to support that problem with a story. Story problems, they are called now. So anything can be transformed, any subject can be taught in the form of a storytelling. Of course, it has its limitations also. Everything means not all everything, but whatever is possible. Most of the things can be transformed into stories. So that we have to take care of and choose the subject or the topic or this type of story that is relevant to the class. Because we are talking about classes 1 to 5. See, what the class 1 child might enjoy, class 5 child might not enjoy in the same level, with the same intensity, same excitement. So you have to change the language, you have to change the activities of the same story. So that needs a lot of practice. So you have to be very careful about what you are delivering to which grade. Like, are you going to tell story to third grade? Then what is that we are talking about? Then if the same story is being told to class 1, then what are the changes you make in that? If the same story is said or told to class 7, what changes would you like to bring in? How much interaction from the child do you expect? Okay, how to accept their answers, how to accept their imagination, all those things you must keep in mind. Okay, now after talking about these basic points, let me once recall what we have talked about. We have talked about story, what are stories and why do we need stories? Why? What is the importance of stories? Why do stories matter at all? How do they help us? Then we talked about how they are the carriers of our culture, how they boost our comprehension, how they help us in learning, relaxing, everything. Then we talked about elements of story, where we said there are 4 elements basically. They are setting, characters, problem and solution. Then we also talked about the storytelling as an art. It has a narrative and it is a performing art. Okay, storytelling is a performing art. And then why is storytelling important? We have discussed it encourages purposeful talking, it motivates, it gives us lessons, so many other things. N number of things are there which are not possible for me to enumerate for you here in this small session. So you people search and find out how to connect these aspects, these key points of storytelling to your class. And then we also talked about which stories to tell. Okay, we said fables can be said, wherein animals are the important characters. In fact, if you people remember Panchatantra, which is our first story, this thing, where our princes go and study with the guru, those are stories only. So previously education was imparted through stories only. Now let us bring back that at least to some extent. And for this particular thing, you have to believe in the child, that children will understand the story, imagine, and you know, their capacity to understand things is enormous. That we have to believe in. मन इपुड़ नम्माली वाले उनपे भरोसा करना चाहिए कि हाँ बच्चा ये सुनता है, फिर समझता है, इसके बारे में सोचेगा और ये कुछ ना कुछ इसके बारे में उसकी उसके दिमाग में कुछ ना कुछ थिंकिंग चालू होगा और इस वजह से हमको स्टोरी टेलिंग करना चाहिए क्लास में. अदरवाइज अगर हम नहीं बोले, नहीं ये बच्चा क्या समझता, चलो ये लेसन है, इसको ऐसा ही पढ़ा के चले जाएंगे, देन इट वोंट हेल्प. द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग इज यू हैव टू हैव द बिलीव इन द चाइल्ड. ओके नाउ देन ओके नाउ हाउ टू द वेरी आई मीन नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ टू टेल अ स्टोरी. How to tell a story? If with sir's permission.
Yes, please. Yeah, continue a story with a story. Go ahead.
I'll tell a story, sir. I'll try to tell a story because this space is very
okay. It's all right. Whatever it may be. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, yeah. So, if time permits, I'll come and practically show you. right now, I'm going to tell you a story. Are you all interested? Are you all listening? If anybody is sleeping, only the sleeping persons raise your hand. Only the sleeping person. The persons who are sleeping, please raise your hand. How many hands did we get, sir?
Yeah, there are 72 into 2. One.
Okay. This many children are, I mean, students are sleeping. Please listen to my question carefully. I asked, the ones who are sleeping, raise your hand. So you people are raising your hands. So that means you are sleeping. Okay.
Rainis, say yes or no.
Okay, let me change the question. How many are attentive? Raise your hands. Attentive and listening, raise your hands.
14 participants have raised.
Okay,
four members
good.
Have raised their hands. Yeah.
Yeah. Very yeah. Good.
20, right. 30
Thank
members.
You so much.
Yes.
I was just testing whether you people are listening or not.
Yeah.
Right.
30,
so let
30,
me tell 30, you a
40
short
people
story.
Are
a
awake.
Story, long story, but I'll tell you. Some 39 to 40 are awake, sir. The remaining, I don't know.
Just they are sleeping in a.
They are in sleep mode.
Sleep mode, yeah.
Now we have to wake up.
So yeah. With your story, they have to wake up. You have to wake up them.
Yeah. Let me try, sir. Let me try. Okay. Now here we go. Once upon a time, you know, it was not long back, but recently, very recently, or not once upon a time. Which one should we take? Tell me. Let me take recently. Because once upon a time will not involve all these technologies that I'm going to use. So recently, there was an old woman who was living all alone in her house. One day, she went to sleep. And when she got up, she felt very sick. She was not feeling well at all. Her head was aching, her body was paining, and she had a nauseating feeling. Then she felt, oh my God, something is happening to me. Let me go and have something so that I can be set right. Then she goes to her kitchen, takes up some boxes, opens the box, and sees there's nothing. Opens another box, there is nothing. And she's too hungry, but there is nothing to eat. She goes to her fridge, opens the door of the fridge, and there was nothing. Now she was feeling very weak and she wanted something to eat so very badly. Now she went there and she saw another jar which she expected to have some cookies, some biscuits. And when she was moving there, she got a phone call. Tring, 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 tring. Oh, let me see. Who is this? Hello? Can you guess who is there that side? Our first respondent of today's session, the girl who helps her mother. I don't know her name, but the one who responded, "What are you doing in lockdown?" She said, "I'm helping my mother." That girl is there on the phone. Now she said, yeah. "Hello, mama." And the old woman said, "Hello, beta." "Ha, mama, what happened to your voice? Why is it so weak? What happened?" "Oh, beta, I don't know. I'm just feeling so sick. And I'm very, very hungry." "Oh, have you eaten anything? Have you prepared anything?" "No, beta, I have not prepared anything. I don't have energy to prepare anything." "Oh, please come to my house. I am going to have a big party today. Please come to my house." "Oh, okay, beta, I will try to come." "No trying, mama. Please come." "Okay, beta. Okay, I will come." No. It so happened. The mother got energy from her daughter's call. She was feeling so weak. Just a minute back, she said, No. I can't move my hand. I can't move myself." But now when her daughter called and said, "You come to my house, let's have some party," she started dressing up. So can you tell me what all things she did? Just to dress, I mean, she planned to go to her daughter's house. So, yes, there's some message popping up. Okay, I can leave that message. Now, can you people please respond? What all things the mother would do if she has planned to go to her daughter's house? Okay, make a note of it. I hope you people have your pens and notebooks with you. Please make a note of it, then we will come back. Yeah, I am getting some message here. Okay, she combs her hair. Very good, beautiful. And then, okay. Right, sir, someone is texting to me. Combs her hair. Very good, beautiful. Takes her ATM, books a cab. Very good, beautiful. Wears a sari. Yes, wearing a sari. Yes, yes. So, kya kya karte ho nu? Ab beti ke paas jaane ke liye tayar hai nu? Ab tak to amma ya mere se kuch nahi ho raha, mere se kuch nahi ho raha bol rahe the. Abhi kya ho gaya? Beti ka call aaya, bola mummy aa jao. To mummy bade khushi tayar ho gaye. Yes, and Naresh is saying, before that, she eats the cookies she was looking for. Okay, so very good, beautiful. Then, as you all said, she had those cookies. Then she got dressed up very well. Very importantly, she switched off lights and fans, then locked the house, went. Now, you know where did she live? She lived down the hill. And daughter lived up the hill. Now, when she wants to go to her daughter's house, there was no cab, no bus, nothing. You can say it was a sort of lockdown. Now, she wanted to climb the hill. Now, she had those 3 or 4 cookies. She had that energy to climb the hill. She started climbing the hill, holding her walking stick. and she started moving. You people can't see her moving or me moving, but imagine that she is moving very slowly, like how an old woman moves, like that, just to keep herself excited or keep herself energetic. She wanted to sing a song, and she sings a song while getting onto the hill, while climbing the hill. Says, oh, rick-a-tick-a-tick, here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-tick, here I come with my walking stick. And this is how she climbs the hill. And she's going to reaching her daughter's house in a, her daughter's house was at very small distance, and she sings, rick-a-tick-a-tick. Hey! Then she's afraid, oh my God, who is this? Then she saw a wolf. A wolf was standing there. And the old woman, who was very much afraid, said, oh my God, who is this? I can't see you. Old woman, can't you see me? I am a wolf and I am hungry. I am going to eat you up. Oh, wolf, please don't do that. No, I am not going to listen to you. I will eat you up. See, I'll tell you something. What is that something? I'm going to my daughter's house to have a feast. You see, I'm such an old woman. You can see there is nothing in my flat tummy, thin tummy. But when I come back, you see, my tummy will be full with all yummy dishes. Then you can eat me. Okay. There is something reasonable what this old woman says. Okay, old woman, you go now. Thank you, wolf. And the old woman runs to her daughter's house. She knocks the door. Daughter opens the door. And she says, oh, mama. Hi, beta, how are you? Come, mama, come. I have prepared so many dishes for you. Now, can anybody tell me what could be those dishes? Please, text and tell me. What could be those dishes? Faster. What are the different dishes you expect?
Can I, ma'am?
Yeah, please.
It may be cake, cookies,
okay.
Biryani.
Bushra is saying biryani, pastries, pizzas.
Burger.
Very good. Some cookies. Okay. Some payasam. Very good. Beautiful. Right.
Some juice.
Maybe. That is, yeah. Sweet. Yeah, some sweet lovers there. Some soup, some tea. Very good. Now, thank you so much. Thank you for your responses. Now, the daughter really made many dishes and made her mother eat all those dishes. And she said, mama, how are they? And the old woman said, beta, they are very delicious. Then my daughter said, are you happy now? Yes. Yes, I'm happy. Mama, what happened, mama? Why are you crying? This may be my last meal, beta. Last meal? Why is that so? I met a wolf on my way, and I promised that it can eat me while I am going back to my house. Oh, mama, then I must think of some plan, some idea to save you. There is no saving, beta. I am going to die. This was my last meal. Oh, mama, don't say that. Come, you have this pumpkin soup I have made for you. You have this soup and take some rest. Meanwhile, I'll think of some idea. And the old woman had that soup you also have some sloop, everybody, with slurping sound if possible, if no one is around you. I think there's no one around me, I can have that slurping sound. Is it not so yummy? Yes. Now, the old woman had that soup and then she went to bed. The daughter started thinking, I must do something. I must do something for my mother. Think of some idea and then save her. Then she got an idea. When her mother woke up, and she said, yes, beta, mama, come here, come to our backyard. Then they, when these two went to the backyard, what did the mother find? There was a huge pumpkin. And the daughter removed all the pulp from inside, made a hole, asked her mother to sit in the pumpkin. Then she said, mama, I'll close this pumpkin, make two holes so that you can go down the, yes, okay, go down the hill and reach your house so that you can escape from the wolf. Mother said, okay, beta, that is a good idea. Let me do that. Now, your daughter made her mother sit comfortably in the pumpkin, huge pumpkin it was. And the old lady was correctly fitting in. And the mother made two holes so that the mother can see. And then she closed the tip of that pumpkin and she said she rolled down the pumpkin. And the pumpkin was rolling down the hill. And who was there waiting for the old woman? Can anybody tell me?
The wolf.
Wolf, very good. Now, the wolf was waiting for the old woman. And it could smell the old woman. I can smell the old woman, but I can't see her. Now, it saw the old pumpkin rolling down. Then it put its leg on it and stopped the pumpkin. Hey, pumpkin. Yes. Have you seen an old woman? No. Why are you all stopping me? Please let me go. I can smell an old woman, but I can't see her. Have you seen the old woman? No. I haven't seen any old women, but I'm getting late now. Please let me go. Are you sure? Yes, I am sure. Please let me go now. Now the disappointed wolf let the pumpkin roll away. When the pumpkin reached the foot of the mountain hill, the old woman got out of the pumpkin, reached her house safely and enjoyed the remaining day. This is the story.
Very nice. Yeah. Good.
Somehow I tried it, sir. This is the first time I'm trying it on a web.
Yeah. Very nice. Very nice. Trainees? Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Now, here, there are two things that I have to talk about. One is the tips of storytelling. Then the post storytelling activities. Okay. Then let me tell you, there might be some lapses in my storytelling, but you have to keep to them when you are performing in front of the class, you know, live audience, like. Now you people are not in front of me, so that I was not so effective, but still I tried my best. Let me tell you, these are the tips for post-telling. As we are running of time, I think I will tell you what actually you people can do and much more than this. Can you see?
Yeah, tips for a story. Plan your read. Somebody could read. Can read it. Will you read?
Yes, sir.
Shall I? Bhargavi, no.
Okay, sir. You can read, Bhargavi, sir.
You okay. Chance for others.
Okay, sir.
Bhargavi, you helped your mother. That's enough.
Yeah. Keep like that only. Now plan your. Yes, please read out.
Myself, I will do, sir. Ma'am, please show once.
Yes.
मैडम कुछ बात करो मैडम आप बात करें तो आप स्क्रीन पर आते
हैं अच्छा आप लोग बताओ ना यहाँ पर क्या लिखा हुआ है टिप पर तो स्टोरी टेलिंग करके हमने या प्लान योर स्टोरी समबडी इज टेक्सटिंग लेकिन विनेश्री चोपुमा
विनेश्री
प्लीज अनम्यूट योर ऑडियो एंड रीड दैट आउट सो दैट एवरीबडी कैन लिसन टू दैट
प्लान योर स्टोरी यूज सिंपल लैंग्वेज
या
इन आई कॉन्टेक्ट
Yes.
Make your voice.
Yes.
At important moments, mm-hmm. interact, create sound effectively.
Yes. Actually, again, if you can see, there are some arrows. I'm leaving them like that so that you people can fill them up. And see, when you are telling a story, what is more important is you must plan it very well. Then your planning must be executed. When you are interacting with the live audience, please make sure that you make eye contact. And so that the connection doesn't break. Then you see, you have to modulate your voice. If you people have seen that I have tried old women's voice, the girl's voice and group's voice, which I couldn't do it at my best because I'm surrounded by my neighbors. They may, you know, object to that if I make sounds like wolf and all. And then your facial expressions are important. Your gestures are important. Very important. Facial expressions, gestures, your body language, your body movement. And you see, I have tried to maintain that the position of the characters. Because I am standing in one place. Hardly I have a 1 square foot area to move. So I tried to keep my position so that, say, for example, from here, if this is from this side, I was depicting the daughter's character. And when I came this side, I was trying to act as old woman. So that is very important when you actually show, tell this story to the kids. Because you are the only one who is telling story to them, they will be imagining different things. If you stick to one place and they will understand this is that particular character speaking. This is the daughter's character and this is the old woman's character. Maybe wolf also has come to one side because I have only two sides here. Okay. And the voice modulation and all those things we said. And then, interact with children, interact with the audience. In between. Here it was not possible, but still I tried to elicit some answers which were excellently good. And the response was extremely encouraging. And that if it was in live, the children would have enjoyed it better. And where they will be giving you, different answers because they are under no stress at all. They'll be giving beautiful answers to you and you'll be eliciting different things, which we are going to have a check on that. And then, as I said, you see, you must, here it was not possible for me, but I'll post those pictures to Jani Reddy, sir, if possible. You can make hand puppets, you can make finger puppets, wherein you can use those puppets also moving, and tell story. You can use any number of props to tell story. Okay. Usage of props should be very apt. Just because you have those things, you cannot use them. They should be very, very apt. अपने पास है बहुत सारे क्या बोलते टॉयज है बहुत सारे पपेट्स है हम बना लेते हैं उसको यूज कर लेते हैं उसको ज्यादा ऐसा अननेसेसरी यूज करके बच्चों को कंफ्यूज भी करना नहीं है अपने को और हमको ये बात ज्यादा ध्यान में रखना है कि बच्चा इसको समझ के फिर अपने से इंटरैक्ट हुए जैसा रहना उसको कंफ्यूज करके वो स्टोरी का कुछ अभी बोले उसका खिचड़ी नहीं बनाना है ओके దాన్ని మనం ఏం చేస్తున్నాం ఏం వాడుతున్నాం అది కరెక్ట్ గా ఉండాలి ఎక్కువ ఎక్కువ అనవసరమైన ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్స్ ఇయ్యొద్దు జెస్టర్స్ అనవసరమైన ఇయ్యొద్దు బాడీ లాంగ్వేజ్ కూడా లిమిటెడ్ గా డీసెంట్ గా పెట్టాలి మనం ఏమి ఏమంటారు చూపిస్తున్నాం జెస్టర్స్ తోని అది కూడా చాలా బాగుండాలి యూనో కనెక్టెడ్ రిలేటెడ్ ఉండాలి ఇవన్నీ బాగా దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకొని చేయాలమ్మా ఏం చేసినా కానీ మళ్ళీ క్వశ్చన్స్ అడిగేటప్పుడు పిల్లల్ని క్వశ్చన్ షుడ్ బి ఓపెన్ టు ఆల్ నేను పర్టికులర్ గా ఇప్పుడు సే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఒక నేమ్ వచ్చింది ఇందాక మనకి బుష్రా భార్గవి వినయ శ్రీ ఇట్లా ఎవరో శ్రీ వినయ లైక్ దట్ నేను వాళ్ళని ఒక్కళ్ళనే పేరు పెట్టి అడిగినా అనుకోండి బుష్రా నువ్వు చెప్పమ్మా ఆన్సర్ అని అంటే మిగిలిన వాళ్ళు థింకింగ్ ఆపేస్తారు దిస్ మీరు మనం సైకాలజీ దాంట్లో కూడా చదువుకొని ఉంటాం అందుకే క్వశ్చన్ ఎప్పుడు కూడా ఓపెన్ గా ఉండాలి ఆన్సర్ కోసం మనం వెతుకుతున్నట్టు ఉండాలి ఎవరిని లేపుతాం అనేది వాళ్ళకి తెలియదు సో వాళ్ళు ఎంత అటెంటివ్ గా ఉంటారంటే ఇంకా ఉత్సాహంగా కూడా ఉంటారు చాలా ఎంతూజియాస్టిక్ గా ఉంటారు నేను చెప్తా సో క్వశ్చన్ ఎప్పుడు ఓపెన్ గా అడగాలి దెన్ యూ షుడ్ ట్రై టు గెట్ డైవర్సిఫైడ్ ఆన్సర్స్ ఒక్క ఆన్సర్ మాత్రమే ఉంటది అని మనసులో ఫిక్స్ అయి ఉండదు పిల్లలకు మనం థింకింగ్ డెవలప్ చేస్తున్నాం కనుక వాళ్ళ పర్స్పెక్టివ్ ని మనం యాక్సెప్ట్ చేసేటట్టు ఉండాలి ఈ పర్స్పెక్టివ్ యాక్సెప్టెన్స్ అనేది చాలా చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఎందుకంటే మనం టీచర్స్ గా మనకు ఒక పర్స్పెక్టివ్ ఉంటది యాజ్ అన్ ఇండివిజువల్ టీచర్ గా ఉండడానికి వీల్లేదు యాజ్ అన్ ఇండివిజువల్ డెఫినెట్ గా ఉంటది ఇప్పుడు ఒక స్టోరీలో ఎవరు రైట్ ఎవరు రాంగ్ ఎట్లా చేస్తే బాగుంటది అనే దానికి మనకు ఒక ఐడియా ఉంటది వాళ్ళు అట్లా చెప్తేనే కరెక్ట్ అనేసి అనుకోవద్దు మనం వాళ్ళ ఐడియాస్ ఏమి ఇచ్చినా గానీ మనం దాన్ని యాక్సెప్ట్ చేయాలి అట్లా యాక్సెప్ట్ చేస్తుంటే వాళ్ళ థింకింగ్ పవర్ పెరుగుతుంది
What are the different activities you can assign based on the stories to help the children to learn the language?
Yes. ఇందాకనే మనం చూసినాము ఒక కొన్ని say for example ఇందాక మాట్లాడుతూ కూడా కొన్ని చెప్పినా నేను వొకాబులరీ అది చూసుకోమని
నీరజ లెట్ దెమ్ సీ పోస్ట్ టెల్లింగ్ డ్రా యువర్ ఫేవరెట్ సీన్ యా సంబడి రీడ్ ఇట్ యాక్ట్ అవుట్ సీన్ మోనోలాగ్ ఆఫ్ ఎనీ క్యారెక్టర్ సీక్వెన్స్ ద స్టోరీ లీవ్ అన్ అదర్ ఎండింగ్ జూమ్ ఇన్ జూమ్ అవుట్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ ఇంటర్వ్యూ ద క్యారెక్టర్ ఓకే దట్స్ గ్రేట్ నౌ యూ ఆస్క్ ద ట్రైనీస్ సే ఫ్యూ నేమ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద క్యారెక్టర్స్ ఇన్ ద స్టోరీ అండ్ ద సమ్ డైలాగ్స్ నీరజ వై డిడ్ యు ఆస్క్ దెమ్ టు
yes let them write some yes sir whoever can
hello trainees Now you can write some of the vocabulary from the story and dialogues from the story what you have now just watched what Neeraja has narrated the story now Neeraja teacher has narrated now what you have to do is you have to write the names of the characters in the story the events the dialogues the images that comes to your mind
draw images anything you can do write yeah. some action words
from the story
somebody rikatikatik
yeah all of you write only in the chat general chat everyone yes all of you
general yeah
so some of you can draw pictures
old
pictures related to the context pumpkin. The context also you can depict through pictures also old lady daughter wolf yeah, pumpkin
that you can do
yeah grandmother okay dust okay what are the other events what are the different events happened in this story
yeah name the events
hill okay image is hill is one image yeah what about delicious recipes okay. also
summarize yes old woman daughter sick okay very good somebody has posted
cookies walking stick went up to the hill to meet her daughter okay daughter. That is one
Very
event
good. Madiha is saying that madiha is she yeah. Ranatika's daughter or what
okay
yes ma'am you might know my mother
yeah okay Rana madiha okay, right
walking stick pumpkin soup okay Can anybody draw one picture related to the story context? Any event, you take any event, just draw picture and show it
very
to
very rough a... picture, very rough picture. Don't try to refine it.
Yes.
A rough draft.
While pumpkin is rolling, tree stops. Not a tree, tree stop. Pumpkin and at that, wolf sees a pumpkin. Yeah, okay. Which part you like the most from the story?
Yes.
Which part, which event you like the most from the story?
Daughter gives an idea for her mother.
Oh, great.
Daughter giving idea to her mother. Okay,
very good. Yes? What else?
When the old lady rolls down in the pumpkin.
Yeah, that is the great idea for Madiha. Okay, next. Which part do you like the most? When wolf stops the lady.
Oh, wolf. They have put the picture of wolf there.
Very nice, very nice.
When grandmother is going to face the wolf. Very
yeah,
good.
Yeah, yes, good.
I personally like when the daughter calls the mother to come for the party.
Very good. Somebody should draw and show it, the event of the story, any event.
Any event, one event. Just draw and just switch on your videos and show it on the screen.
Yeah. Yes. The remaining can write on the chart, the dialogues that you like the most, the events that you like the most. Ricka ticka tick. Okay. Come with my walking stick. Ricka ticka tick. Ricka ticka tick.
Here I come with
my walking stick.
Actually, yes. This is a very long story, kids.
Yes.
But I have, shortened it to such this thing. I really wonder.
Here I come with my walking stick. Yes.
Here,
that's great.
There can be another activity, sir.
What is that?
See, while the old woman was climbing the hill, she sang a song. There
yeah.
could be a song while she is rolling down also.
Yes, what
somebody
is that?
You can write that song also.
Okay, okay. Old woman, I am going to eat up. Okay, yeah. Wolf is saying. Yeah, Vinay Sri. Mm, yeah. Ha 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 ha. Old
you
woman.
See? Okay.
Yes, next dialogues. I want to see somebody should draw a picture and show to us. Do you think all these are the language?
So.
Roll around and roll, roll, roll. Yeah, that is the, see.
Song, yeah.
Roll around, roll, roll, roll. Roll, pumpkin, roll. Roll down the hill. Roll around, roll, roll, roll. Very good, very good. Nice. Aishwarya and Sujata. So this is how children enjoy and learn the language.
Yes, sir. You see, I just wanted to show you, what can be done. You can elicit vocabulary items, like how I ask you people to tell me the food items and all. So this could be some of the answers if you see.
Food items, chicken, biryani, sambar, oh, gulab jam, oh, very good.
I wanted to show, sir. Like
okay.
this can be done, Bulke. I thought I won't get so much of time to elicit from them.
Yes, okay, okay.
These people are very prompt and answer.
Yeah.
Action words you can ask.
Action words, yeah.
You can ask Break. For adjectives, anything.
Dialogues.
Okay.
So this is
now
how...
if you see, what are the things she does?
Yes, gets dressed. Combs her hair, wears specs, takes her bag, takes her mobile. Oh, very good. Closes taps, switches off the light and fan. Oh, right. Very good. So these are all what she prepares before leaving the home.
Yeah, all these can be elicited from children. And
very
finally,
good.
When you are giving, there are n number of activities which you can search and which you can plan yourself. If I have given a conversation to write between the wolf and the old woman, most probably this could be a possible conversation.
Conversation, okay. Can you read it yourself?
Me? Okay, sir. Wolf, stop, old woman. Old woman, who are you? Wolf, I am a wolf and I am hungry. Old woman. What do you want? I want to eat you, old woman. Not now, please. Wolf, why? Then when? Old woman, when I come back from my daughter having a feast. Wolf, okay. Thank you. Wait for me.
Very good. Good conversation. This is a one discourse they can develop through the storytelling.
Yeah, through the, yes.
Great.
I mean, I just planned it, but yeah, I mean, there can be better conversations. This is just one. Yes. Those people are open to ask anything now, sir.
Any picture? Anybody has come with picture?
Yeah, pictures, doubts, anything you people can ask me now.
Yeah.
I'll try to clarify.
Madam, good morning, madam. This is Rama.
Good morning, sir.
Ramachar.
I know you, sir.
Okay. Really, it's a wonderful session, ma'am. You've given us so much of exposure regarding how you had narrated the story with the action. This is really we need for primary level, madam. It's a wonderful.
Yes, sir.
Our trainees also participated very actively. Almost like running from past 2 months. Today is it is a live session, man. This is called a live session, interactive session. Whatever the questions, your the way your presentation is very, 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 very nice, madam. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Trainees, thank you. Now you can interact with ma'am. Really, she is the state level resource person and textbook writer. Just now, professor said, well known to in Hyderabad. See how simple she is. How she has good at Urdu, English, Hindi, Telugu, all. So you have to develop by seeing her. So you have to inculcate some values from her, not only for the content. So how she is freely, how you can express as a teacher in the classrooms, call if you see.
How a primary teacher should be?
Yes, sir. Example. So thank you, sir. Really, manchi madam parichayam chesaru mana pillalaku.
Now you can interact now. Ask the questions. Any question
yes,
to ma'am?
Yes, now you can ask regarding today's session, especially. Otherwise, if you ask anything regarding primary level also.
Related to storytelling also. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Regarding storytelling or anything related to primary English classroom, I'll try my best to answer.
Today's session only. Yeah.
See how this word shows how simplicity she shows. Yeah, trainees, now this is your session. Yeah, wow. Naresh, I think.
Sir, we are seeing a picture.
Yeah, show it in a
Naresh.
Round it, ma. You can turn it. Turn it.
Someone has drawn a picture like
Naresh, madam. Naresh, be Naresh.
Yeah, yeah. Nice. Show it, Naresh. Show it.
Wonderful. Naresh, you can say something so that we can see.
Sir, your audio is not clear, sir. Not audible to us.
Naresh, show it. No, you say something. Wolf or old woman, something. Yeah, yes. You can show it.
Wolf say stop.
Yeah, pumpkin. No, stop. Okay, dialogue also. Very good. Oh, wonderful. Stop pumpkin. Very nice. Go, good. Great. Yeah.
Madam, this is the feedback to you, madam.
Yeah, super.
Nice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, this is how we can create interest, motivation among the children, and they can see now through the picture they have written dialogue. See, Naresh has written dialogue. This is how children will come out with their own language. Great. Yeah. Next, anybody has a drawn picture?
One word, sir. One word, please, sir. A picture is a worthwhile of 1,000 words, sir. Really, it can impact.
Yes.
So impact, sir.
Yeah. See, this is now, the second thing is you can also give the opportunity for the students to expose their skills, their abilities. Yes, somebody can act, somebody can draw, somebody can do something. See, like that, somebody can read and somebody can, this is how the different skills, see? This is called, every child has their own abilities. You have to provide an opportunity for them.
Yes. Here our options are limited. But when you go to live audience in the classroom, you have unlimited options. And you'll be overwhelmed by the response.
Exactly.
The children, they will not, let you keep quiet. You'll enjoy like anything, I'm telling you.
They can act also, can enact the dramatization.
Yeah, act, you know.
Yeah.
Yes. Sir, they can, you don't mind telling, no, sir?
Yeah. What is that?
Dhani Reddy sir also acted this.
Yes, yes. Sir. Me too acted.
Venkatesh Rao sir.
Yeah.
Venkatesh Rao sir, you can, if you want to say anything, you can.
Sir, sir.
Oh, namaste, sir.
Amma.
Namaste, namaste, madam.
Venkatesh Rao sir. Bhavnara, sir.
Bhavnara, madam. Thank you. Very, very nice, sir.
Yeah, it's an order. You see, this should not take much time. The whole 45 minutes period should not be dedicated to this thing every day. Okay, 5 to 6 minutes. But for that, you need to plan and prepare well in advance. Yes, anybody else?
Trainees?
Can I add one word better here?
Pre-reading,
while reading, post-reading. Similarly, pre-telling the story, while telling, and after telling.
Yes. Sir.
Yeah. Different activities.
Those things can be modified as per our needs, sir.
So now the assignment is choose a story and plan how you want to teach your students for third class or fifth class, and what activities will you take up before telling, while telling, after telling. This is assignment. Yeah, choose a story, plan, and third one, choose a story, plan, and what are the activities pre, before, while, after. Activities. And finally, you have to write how a story will helpful in learning a language. Yeah, outcomes means how stories will help the children learning English language. That is the last one. You have to submit this assignment. All of you has to work on it, and you have to send it in the group.
Right, yeah. Sir.
Anything, trainees? If at all, if you have any questions, so ma'am will answer. Otherwise, we will close the session. Hello, finally, anything anybody wants to? Naresh? Naresh, sir. Is there? Yeah. Do you want to say anything?
Nothing, sir. Okay, I understood.
Etla anpinchindi nanna?
Bagundi, sir. Ante baga ardhamaindi, sir.
Baga ardhamaindi. Nuvvu em cheyagalavu? Out of this, what can you do?
Sir, ante.
Yes, you can. You can tell.
స్టోరీస్ ఎట్లా చెప్పాలో అర్థమైంది సార్ అంటే
ఓకే ఎట్లా చెప్పాలని అర్థమైంది రైట్ ఎట్లా మరి స్టోరీస్ ని ఎట్లా ఉపయోగించుకోవచ్చు మనం లాంగ్వేజ్ కి
కొన్ని వర్డ్స్ ఉంటాయి కదా సార్ రిపీటెడ్ వర్డ్స్ తర్వాత
పిల్లల్ని చెప్పవనంటాం వొకాబులరీ ఇందులో ఏమేమి మీరు విన్నారు ఇప్పుడు స్టోరీలో కొన్ని వర్డ్స్ చెప్పవనటము ఓకే దట్ ఈస్ వన్ యాక్టివిటీ ఇంకా
క్యారెక్టర్స్ పేర్లు తర్వాత
క్యారెక్టర్స్ పేర్లు yes very good
కొన్ని డైలాగ్స్ చెప్పమని
డైలాగ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద స్టోరీ యా
ఇంకా
యు కెన్ డ్రా యు కెన్ ఆస్క్ దెం టు డ్రా అండ్ రైట్ ద రిలేటెడ్ డైలాగ్స్ ఆర్ ఈవెంట్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ఓకే
పిక్చర్స్ డ్రాయింగ్
యా పిక్చర్ డ్రాయింగ్ ద పిక్చర్స్ రిలేటెడ్ టు ద ఈవెంట్ ఒక సంఘటనకి సంబంధించినది డ్రా చేయటము దానికి సంబంధించి రాయటము అండ్ ఆస్ ద చిల్డ్రన్ విచ్ పార్ట్ దే లైక్ ద మోస్ట్ అండ్ వై ఏ పార్ట్ బాగా వాళ్ళకి ఇష్టము ఎందుకు
ఏ క్యారెక్టర్ ఆల్సో వి కెన్ ఆస్క్
యా క్యారెక్టర్ ఆల్సో విచ్ క్యారెక్టర్ యు లైక్ ద మోస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద స్టోరీ
దేర్ ఇస్ అనదర్ యాక్టివిటీ కాల్డ్ జెండర్ బెండర్ సర్
జెండర్ బెండర్ వాట్ ఇస్ దట్ నీరజ
ఐ మీన్ ఇఫ్ ద ప్రొటగనిస్ట్ ఇస్ అ మేల్ ఇఫ్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ఇఫ్ షీ ఇస్ అ ఐ మీన్ ఇఫ్ ద ప్రొటగనిస్ట్ ఇస్ అ ఫీమేల్
యా
How will she or he, I mean, what changes will the story take place in the story?
Okay, what way they have to change
will,
that?
How will they, this helps the children to understand that the genders are equal like.
Yeah. Oh, very nice.
Yes, sir. అర్థమైంది. ఓల్డ్ మదర్ కి వాళ్ళ కూతురు కాకుండా వాళ్ళ కొడుకు ఫోన్ చేస్తే ఎట్లే.
వెరీ గుడ్. యా, దట్స్ జెండర్ బ్లెండర్.
కాకుండా ఓల్డ్ ఫాదర్ కూడా పెట్టొచ్చు అన్నమాట.
ఓకే, వెరీ గుడ్. దట్ ఇస్ అ జెండర్ బ్లెండర్. జెండర్ ని బ్లెండ్ చేయటం. బ్లెండ్ అంటే అటు ఇటు మార్చటం. బ్లెండ్. యా, very good.
If you find time, you explain that also, sir. Zoom in and zoom out are also beautiful.
Yeah, zoom in and zoom out. Yeah, very good. Cheppu Neeraja, zoom in zoom out vallaki brief ga cheppesi.
Zoom in ante nemo adha name chestam manam size ni
tagistam.
Okay. Size ni tagistam ante ippudu, yeah, you the activity takes it in this way. మనం ఎవరైనా ఒకళ్ళు వచ్చి స్టోరీ చెప్తూ ఉంటారు అక్కడ ఒక గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ దెన్ సే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇప్పుడు చెప్పిన స్టోరీ చెప్తూ ఉంటే ద ఓల్డ్ ఉమెన్ వాజ్ సిక్ అనగానే మనం జూమ్ అవుట్ అంటాం. ఇక్కడ బయట ఉన్న ఆడియన్స్ ఎవరైనా జూమ్ అవుట్ అంటే వాళ్ళు ఏం చేయాలి, ఆ పిక్చర్ ని పెద్దగా చేసి చెప్పాలి మనకు.
సిక్ గా ఉండాలి అంటే
ఓల్డ్ ఉమెన్ షీ హ్యాడ్ రింకిల్స్ ఆన్ హర్ ఫేస్, షీ హ్యాడ్ గ్రే హెయిర్, షీ వాజ్ వెరీ వీక్, వెరీ థిన్, షీ వాజ్ ట్రెంబ్లింగ్, ఇట్లా అంత జూమ్ అవుట్ చేసి ఆమె డిస్క్రైబ్ చేయాలి. అట్లా డిస్క్రైబ్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు మనం జూమ్ ఇన్ అనగానే మళ్ళీ అక్కడికి కట్ చేసేసి దే షుడ్ మూవ్ ఆన్ విత్ ద స్టోరీ. ఆమె ఫుడ్ తింటుంది, ఫుడ్ తింటున్నప్పుడు ఐ ఫినిష్ ఇట్ ఇన్ వన్ సెంటెన్స్, షీ హ్యాడ్ దట్ ఫీస్ట్ అని చెప్పి. ఇఫ్ యూ సే జూమ్ అవుట్ దెన్ దేర్ వాజ్ అ డెలీషియస్ చికెన్ బిర్యానీ and she was eating that leg piece. It was a very tasty one, you know. The rice was so fluffy, you can say fluffy, yeah. Fluffy, tasty, whatever. And then there was this kheer which was made with thick milk, some added dry fruits were there that were fried in ghee. So wherein when we say zoom out, you should go on elaborating that particular thing. When we say zoom in, you should cut it short. This is this will work out better for 5th
and 6th class. Yes, zoom in, zoom out. Yeah. So the thing is, where in that context they have to describe it, elaborate
they
it.
Have to.
Yeah, otherwise they will continue zoom out. They will continue.
This
zoom
helps in their out. Comprehending things and imagining things also.
Yeah, they add many things. Yeah. That is a great, great idea. Thank you very much, Neeraja. Thank you for your time and your interaction with our trainees. Really, it's a wonderful session. I hope my trainees might have benefited from this and they will practice the stories during this lockdown also. They can tell the stories, their siblings, their neighbors, kids, and they will try with different activities also. Now, I hope somebody should come and tell us on Monday. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Shari Garu? Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Neeraja. Right.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Shari, sir.
Thank you very much for your session, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.